Welcome to the video lectures on industrial automation. The subject code is EE255 and the name of the subject is industrial automation. In today's lecture, we are going for the discussion of zero order system, first order system, and second order system. So let us start with the mathematical equation of a generalized measurement system, and then let us derive the equations for zero order, first order, and second order system. So let us first go with the generalized mathematical equation for a measurement system. Okay, so let us go for a generalized equation. Now see that general measurement system can be mathematically described by the following differential equation. Okay, so I am just writing the differential equation over here. So we are having An dN plus An minus 1 d raised to n minus 1. We are having A1D plus A0, that is on the output side, I0. On the input side, similarly, we can take another constant B. So we are having Bm D raised to m plus Bm minus 1 d raised to m minus 1, till we can write that is the b1d plus b0 ii. So we are considering a general measurement system with this differential equation. B and A are the constants and D is the differential operator, that is being written as D is equal to D by dt. Okay, so in this equation, this A and these are the constants . Constants depends on the physical parameter which is to be measured by that measuring system. So A, we are considering it on the output side, and B, we are considering it on input side. Okay. D raised to k is the operative derivative of the order k. So So we are taking D as the operative derivative of order K. I0 I stands for the information. So the information out of the measurement system is the I0. In the same way, II is the information inputted or the information input, that is the II. Okay, so this is the mathematical equation for a generalized measurement system. Okay, now in this equation, if we put the value of n is equal to 0, if you put the value of n is equal to 0, then it will become a zero order system. Means from A1 to AN all the terms will be 0, so only A0 will be there for a zero order system. Okay, so for n is equal to 0, it will become a zero order system. If we take n is equal to 1, then this will be the first order system. Okay, so all the terms, that is from A2 to AN, that will be 0. Okay, and when we take n is equal to 2, this will be the second order system. So for second order system, A3 to AN terms will be 0. Okay, and on input side, we will consider II and the B0 term. Okay, so from a general mathematical equation for a measurement system, we can put the value of n on the output side, and we have the zero order system, first order system and second order system. Okay, so let us proceed further with the zero order system first. Let us proceed further with the zero order system. Now see that in the above generalized equation, when we put the value n is equal to 0, the equation that we get, that is A0 I0 is equal to B0 II. This is the equation that we will get when we put n is equal to 0 in the above equation. Okay, so this is what we get. We will get A0 I0 and B0 II. This is what we will get. Okay, so we can write I0 is equal to B0 upon A0 II So this term can be written as sensitivity S. Okay, this term can be written as sensitivity S. So we are having I0 upon II is equal to S. So this term can be written as the sensitivity S. That is the ratio of the information output from the measurement system upon the input information. Okay, so that is being given by the sensitivity. So the block diagram for a zero order system, so information inputted will be II, the information outputted will be I0, and the transfer function is S. Means the zero order systems are the most ideal systems in which whatever the input you will give, you will get the faithful output from the measurement system. Means there are very few changes on the input, okay, and that kind of output you will get from that particular measurement system. Okay, examples of zero order systems are, let me write down the examples. So very simple measurement systems will came under zero order measurement systems. So the examples are, we are having mechanical levers, amplifiers, and potentiometer. So these are the examples of a zero order system, okay, in which whatever the input you will get, give, depending on that you will get the output. The transfer function is sensitivity S. Okay, in case of amplifiers it will become gain. Okay, so these are some zero order systems. So let us proceed further with the first order systems. Let us proceed further. With the first order system. So in the generalized equation, if we put n is equal to 1, we will get the first order system. Okay, so let us find out the transfer function for the same again, as we have done in the zero order system. Okay, now see that in the first order system, if we put n is equal to 1 in the above equation, we will get a1d plus a0 i0 is equal to, we will take only a one constant, that is b0 ii. Okay, for simplicity we are not taking the other terms on the input side. For one input we are taking the n is equal to 1. Okay, now see that if we expand this derivative operator, then it can be written as a1, that is d I0 by dt plus A0 I0 is equal to V0 II. Okay. We will get this equation when we expand the derivative operator by d by dt. Okay. So over here, our derivative operator d we are taking as d by dt. That we are expanding. That is self-explanatory. Okay. Now see that. Now the above equation, if we divide this equation by A0 to simplify it, okay? So we will get A1 by A0 di0 by dt plus I0 is equal to V0 by A0 II. Okay, if we divide the whole equation by A0, this is what we are going to get. Okay, now see that this A1 by A0 can be written as a tau, that is the time constant that is written by tau, that is the time constant, and we know that sensitivity S is our V0 by A0, that is the sensitivity S. Okay, so this equation will change, so instead of this we can write, or we can directly write tau di0 by dt plus I0 is equal to S II. Okay, this is what we get while we put the time constant and sensitivity S in this equation. Okay, again implementing the D operator, again if we implement the D operator, then we get tau di0 plus I0 is equal to S II. Okay, if we take I0 common from here, we will get tau d plus 1 is equal to S II. So finally we will get I0 upon II, that is the transfer function we are calculating, that is S upon 1 plus tau d. This is what we will get. Okay, so for the block diagram of first order system, we are going to use this transfer function. Okay, so for first order system, the input information will be II, output information will be I0, and the transfer function will be S upon 1 plus tau d. This will be the transfer function for the first order measurement system. Let us see the examples. The first example, you can say a velocity of a true falling mass or you can write thermistors and thermocouples are the few examples of first order measurement system. Okay, and the transfer function for the same will be that is the sensitivity S upon 1 plus time constant tau and the derivative operator. Okay, so there are few changes which are being done on the input information signal, and then you will get the output information, that is I0. Okay, depending on the transfer function, the same is being followed by the thermistors and the thermocouples. So they will came under the first order systems. Okay, so let us proceed further with the last, that is the second order systems. Let us proceed further. With the second order system, okay. So for the second order system, in the generalized equation written above, we will write n is equal to 2. We will put n is equal to 2 in the above equation, okay. So what we will get? We will get A2 d square I0 by dt square, if we expand the d, plus A1 d I0 upon dt, plus A0 I0 is equal to B0 II on the input side. Okay, this is what we get when we put n is equal to 0 and we expand the derivative operator. Okay, now see that in this equation, again we will divide it by A0. So we will get, if we divide it by A0, so we will get A2 by A0, A1 by A0. From here, the A0 will be divided by A0, so it will be removed. So we are having plus I0 and we are having B0 by A0. Okay, so if you divide the equation by A0, this is the equation that we will get for the second order system. Okay, now see that for the second order system, there are two parameters that we are supposed to take care of. The first one is the damping ratio, and the second one, the unwanted natural frequency component. Okay, so let the undamped natural frequency component is omega n, and that is being given by root of A0 by A2. Okay, that is our undamped natural frequency . The unit is, that is in radian per second, the unit will be radian per second. Okay, now see that the other parameter that we are supposed to use is gamma, that is a damping ratio, that is A1 divided by 2 root of A0 A2, that is the damping ratio, it is dimensionless. So if we are going to put these two terms in this equation, okay, what we will get? And the third one that we know, S is equal to B0 by A0, is the static sensitivity a steady state gain. Okay. So if we put the undamped natural frequency omega n, damping ratio and static sensitivity or steady state gain in the above equation. Okay, so let us put all these things in this equation. Okay. Let me rub all this. Okay. So if you put all this in the above equation, we will get 1 upon omega n square d square I 0 by dt square plus 2 gamma omega n d I 0 by dt plus I 0 is equal to s of ii. Okay, again instead of this we put the d operator, so you will get d square by omega n square plus 2 gamma omega n d plus 1, we will take I 0 common, is equal to s ii. So finally we will get the transfer function I 0 upon ii is equal to, that is s sensitivity s upon 1 upon undamped natural frequency component omega n square d square. Okay, this will be 1 upon omega n square, d square will come up. Okay, 1 upon omega n square, we are having a d square plus we are having 2 gamma upon omega n d plus 1. So this will be the transfer function. Okay, so if we make the block diagram for second order system, then this will be ii, this will be I 0, okay, and the transfer function will be 1 upon omega n square d square plus 2 gamma omega n d plus 1, that is divided s. So s divided by, okay, so this is the transfer function for the second order system. Okay, now see that the examples for the second order systems are, that is the piezoelectric, that is the piezoelectric pickup. We do have UV galvanometers. Okay. Then we are having a spring mass control or a spring mass system. Okay. Or a pan system with XY quadrants. Okay, so these are the few examples. We are having a piezoelectric pickup, UV galvanometer and a spring mass system. They came under second order systems because they do follow this transfer function. Okay, and the input will be affected by the undamped natural frequency component, that is omega n, and the damping ratio omega. Okay, so for an instrument it is better to write its order as well as the other parameters in terms of the undamped natural frequency and the damping ratio gamma. Okay, so we will be free from this constants A0, A1, A2 and B0. So it is always better to write in terms of the damping ratio and undamped natural frequency gamma for the measurement systems. Okay, so this is how the order of the systems can be derived using a generalized mathematical differential equation for a measurement system. Okay, so in today's lecture we had gone through a generalized equation for a measurement system, and from that we had derived the equation for the first order system, zero order system, first order system and second order system, and we had gone through few examples of the same for the zero order, first order and the second order. Okay, that's all we have for today's lecture. Thank you.